In this video, I'm going to be talking with Roy Moore, Salesforce architect and user group leader, about some of the common questions people have when they start their Salesforce certification journey. I hope you find it useful.
So the next question that comes up when you're on your certification journey is, how do you actually schedule the exam and should you do it on site or online? I'm here with Roy Moore, and we're going to talk about these two questions. I think, Roy, the first thing to talk about and define is, what exactly does on-site or online mean?
Yeah, good question. So when you get to the place where you schedule the exam, you have these two options, on-site and online. On-site is a testing center. There are testing centers set up as independent businesses, at universities and colleges. Some libraries have testing centers. But these are places you go in person to take the test. Online is pretty much what it sounds like. It's online at your home or in your office, where it's convenient for you to take the exam. So that's the difference between on-site and online. However, there is a site and online. On-site is a testing center. There are testing centers set up as independent businesses, at universities and colleges. Some libraries have testing centers, but these are places you go in person to take the test. Online is pretty much what it sounds like. It's online at your home or in your office, where it's convenient for you to take the exam. So that's the difference between on-site and online. However, there is a qualifiable difference between the experiences you might have between the on-site testing and the online testing. I recommend, if you have the option, most people should choose on-site. The reason for that is, when you do online testing at your home or in your office, there are additional requirements that are needed that you don't have to worry about when you're on-site. So there's a camera set up. There's this Big Brother software from Salesforce that you have to download onto your computer. There's all these atmosphere controls that you have to worry about as far as sound around you. And there's a monitor. There's a live person monitoring your test taking. And I've had numerous friends have their online exams stopped by the proctor for the craziest reasons. I had a friend whose exam was stopped because a train went by his window. I had a friend whose exam was stopped because they were next to a conference room that had a birthday party, and they were singing happy birthday in the next room, and it came through the speakers of the computer. exams have gotten stopped because the dogs are barking. One friend was reading the questions out loud to himself, and the proctor actually stopped and spoke up and said, "Who are you talking to?" And he had to like stand up. He had to turn his camera around, show the room in a 360-degree view to show that no one else was there, that he was just talking to himself. And it's just all these hassles. Also, with the Big Brother software, I had a coworker who tried to do the online test, and he tried to put the software on his work computer, and it would not play with the company's security on the work computer. So after several hours of trying to get to play well, he finally had to give up and just go to a testing center because the company box and the security controls. Mac users, Apple users, they have additional things that they have to do of enabling and disabling permissions on their computers. There's a face recognition software that you have to pass, and the lighting has to be just right. So anyway, I'm going on and on, but my point is, online has a bunch of hoops and hurdles to jump through, and the only downside to going on site is you have to drive somewhere. Other than that, I don't see a benefit to doing it online, but that's just my opinion.
And no, I agree. I've done both. And with my online experience, I didn't actually have many hiccups, but it was all the preparation time. It was getting the camera set up at the right angle. It was making sure that, you know, everything was just right. And if you go on site, yes, you can have some travel time, but you know, the travel time you can actually use, you know, you can use it to prepare yourself, to think through things. And then you just go there and it's all set up and you're ready to go and you don't have to worry about any of the logistics.
Plus, we'll get into this in a later conversation. One of my favorite tips for people who are taking the exam, it's something they cannot do online, but they can do on site. But we'll cover that in another conversation. So from Trailhead, the easiest way to get here is to go to Trailhead, look at the certification that you're studying for, and there's a button on there that says Schedule Exam Now. If you click on it, it will bring you to the Criterion Global Testing Solutions Salesforce partner. They're the ones who manage the Salesforce certification exams for Salesforce. The very first time you come to this page, there is a section that says New to Salesforce Certification, and you click on a link that says Create a New Web Assessor Login. When you do that, this is a special note. Do not use your work email. Use a personal email. These are your certifications that you're testing for. And if you leave this job and go to another job, you don't want to have to reach out back to a former employer and say, "Hey, I need to get access to my certifications, please." you want those to go with you. So even if work is paying for them, you still want to set up your web assessor account with your personal email address for future-proofing your career. So with that aside, once you've created your credentials, you go in, you find the certifications that you are looking at, and again, you have the option of online or on-site. You choose one of those, whichever you've decided to do after doing your research. Once you've selected your exam and you've chosen online or on-site, let's assume you've chosen on-site. It'll ask you to help them find the testing center. So you'll put in your country, your province or state. You can give it some boundaries like your postal code or zip code and the range, and it'll tell you what testing centers are within range of the criteria that you've given them. Select all the ones that you think are good potentials. This is for Colorado Springs. This is where I live, and there are two testing centers. So in this example, I've checked both of them. Then you click select, and now it brings you to this calendar tool that lets you choose a day and a time. And let's say Pikes Peak didn't have anything I liked when I was looking to schedule this. Well, then I could go down to the AccuSkillen, the other testing center that's close enough for me to drive to, and check out the calendar for that one. But through one of those two testing centers and through one of these two calendar and start time tools, I could choose a date and time and location for the exam. And then once I've done that, I have the day, I have the location, I have the time, I have the price, I have everything I need to know about the exam. I'm ready to check out, except look at that box right in the middle. What do you think about that?
So I can see that's a coupon or a voucher code. So I wonder how I'd get one of those.
Yeah, so you might be saying, how do I score with those coupons and voucher codes? There's a few different ways you can get those. The most common ways are certification days through Salesforce's Trailblazer community. There's a group called Certification Days. You should definitely join that and follow it. If you go through one of their certification day preps, they'll give you some sort of coupon. They'll give you a discount. Also, there are discounts for nonprofits. Nonprofits can take exams for 50% the cost. We'll talk about how to get one of those in just a moment if you happen to be a nonprofit. And then there's also Salesforce events around the globe. When they have Salesforce events that are in person, at least, I'm not sure about the virtual ones that we're having a lot of these past couple of years, but the in-person ones often baked into the registration is a voucher or two. And so that's something to keep in mind. But those are some of the most common ways. And then also, if you are a member of your local Salesforce community group, attend those regularly because sometimes the leaders of those groups are given vouchers to give away as prizes to attendees. So those are a few different ways you can get coupons and vouchers. If you work at a nonprofit, you can get 50% off your voucher price by working at a nonprofit. Now, there are some caveats to that, and that's what this page talks about. You do need to be a full-time employee, not a volunteer, not part-time. But if you're a full-time employee at a nonprofit, you can send an email to nonprofitcertification@salesforce.com. Tell them that you're a full-time employee at a nonprofit. Ask them for a certification. Say please and thank you. If you don't, they'll still give you one, but I th just think it's nice to say please and thank you. And then within 3 business days, you'll probably get a response with a one-off code. That code is for a one-time use. It's for you. The fine print on this is that you're not to give this code away to other people. It's just for your use. If you have a coworker at the nonprofit with you and they want a code, then tell them to do the same thing you did. But this is your code for you. You get up to 5 total, and they're for your exams. They're not for retakes. They're not to be shared. And there is actually a line in the email where Salesforce says abuse, as in giving away this code to for-profit friends or selling them or whatever. Abuse may lead to Salesforce not being able to offer this discount in the future. So that is a tip for those of you who work at nonprofits.
That's a really good tip. And 50% discount code, if you're doing a number of certifications, that can really add up.
Especially when you get to the architect level, because some of those certifications are $400 certifications.
Right. And yeah, I mean, you know, a lot of people, they get up to 10 certs, 20 certs. How many certs have you got, Roy, at the moment?
I have 11 now.
You have 11. So if you think about the discounts, and as Roy mentioned, on the architect level, you know, that really adds up.
There's a loophole. And the loophole is, as long as you schedule the exam before it expires, you're okay. You don't have to schedule the exam before the expiration date. You just have to schedule the exam before the voucher expires.
Right. And so that comes back to our point before around like actually setting a goal and actually scheduling it and working towards that. So this is an extra motivation to make sure that you do that and don't lose your discount.
Absolutely.